Hello, Brother Munro here. Welcome back to Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts and a brand new campaign. I am using the mod that I am making, which is currently in testing. It's not ready for public release. Don't worry, when it's actually ready for public release, I will be talking all about it, and there will be a public link, probably on Nexus Mods, but I will also post it up in the Game Labs forums and stuff, but that's all still to come, because, yeah, I need to actually test it, which means, well, what better way to test it than to actually play a campaign? The results are in from the community poll, and you guys have chosen Japan, actually by a fairly big majority. Japan. So I'm going to start in 1900 because 1890 is terrible. I am going to play on normal difficulty, I think, simply because I think most people play on normal, so it's good to test on normal. But as well, the mod makes things harder. So, yeah, normal, we're going to go historical AI opponents. We are not going to auto-generate a fleet. We are going to create our own. And AI shared designs, I'm going to leave on selective. I do have some shared designs loaded thanks to Omni on the Discord server. One of the things I do want to do with the mod is to eventually have a ship pack to go along with it. And to be honest, even just having a few shared designs in the folder just makes things faster and more efficient. So I'm going to start this campaign. I'm going to load it up, which can take a while. I'll let you know how long it takes. And I'll see you for the design process. All right, 16 minutes later, which is actually not too bad. The campaign has loaded. So, looking at our starting position, we do start with Formosa or Taiwan, depending on what you want to call it. It's called Formosa in the game. So I'll be calling it Formosa for this. Is already under our control. So is the Korean Peninsula. So we do start off with a little bit more than just the home islands, which is quite handy. Obviously, we're going to have to deal with the Crease of Doom, but can try our best. Probably going to get into war with Russia very early on. That tends to happen in the 1900s start. Obviously, war with China is definitely possible as well. And maybe countries like Britain, France, Germany, and the US. So, yeah, we're going to have to be cautious. I think the only country that we don't really care about what countries are Spain and Italy and Austria. So, yeah, the three Mediterranean powers we're not really very interested in, but we'll do our best. So, in this first episode, I'm going to design our capital ships, and then I'll do the cruisers and smaller ships in the second one. Basically, I'll see how it goes. Maybe the builds will go nice and fast. So, battleship. I'm not doing an artisan campaign, so I have freedom of choice here. The semi-dreadnought is the technically the best one, I think, but it actually has lower resistance than the Battleship 2. One thing I do want to do with the mod, by the way, is to go through and harmonize these values across the different hulls and stuff, but that's a lot of work, so that's for another time. This one has better hull form, better stability, less floatability. It is slower, though. This one can do 18 knots. So, yeah, let's go with the semi-dreadnought. Let's go with the semi-dreadnought. 18 knots is not an unreasonable speed. It's a pretty big weight range. I'm going to go for 17,000 tons on the Kanko here. And I'm going to set everything to medium because that tends to be how building kind of goes with this. So main tower, base accuracy is the, yeah, we just want as much base accuracy as possible. I don't envision keeping these for very long. But they're going to be our frontline unit for a while. So we're all Mark IIs, are we? Yes. Okay, we could go for a 12-inch fore and aft. That's very conventional. Funnels, yes, we're going to need some funnels. And secondary guns would be nice. Mark II, Mark III. Mark II. Weird. Get 7-inch Mark IIIs. They're huge. They do fit, though. Okay, looks very weird with the 7-inch guns, but all right. Casements, both Mark II, so I might as well use the 3-inches. And torpedo launchers? They can be useful on this type of ship. So we'll stick them on. Kitchen sink approach. Okay. Cool. Coal. Oh, Jesus. Triple expansion induced. Yeah, that works. Obviously go for the best armor. There's really no... Well, there is a cost advantage for going with less armors, but no, we want the best armor we can get. Anti-tilt one. Yes, please. Now, I normally go increased AP on a battleship, but this is so early. I'm thinking I'm going to go standard ratio, and I'm going to bring base fuse and capped AP. Ugh, black powder is terrible. So, yeah, gun cotton. Okay, white powder. It gives us gun range, pen, the lighter, and then 1% accuracy. Yeah, that's not bad. But the ballastite gives us more range, more pen, but less accuracy. I think I'm going to go with white powder. Poudre B. Standard shells, because I don't want to explode. 18-inch standard torps, I think. And a coincidence rangefinder. Lovely. Okay, what is my armor quality? 75%. All right. There we go. Wish you could type that in. Okay. Armor. What are we looking at? Yeah, about 12-inch. Okay, that's good. 12-inch protect us out to 7,500 meters. Assuming we can get it. No? Yeah, we can. That'd be fine. Let's start with 12-inch. And then deck armor. We just need some deck armor. 1.5 will be perfectly sufficient. Okay, what about HE pen? So we're talking about 3-inch tops from the 12-inch. And like 1, 1.5 for the 7s. What's the AP like on the 7s? 5, 6-inch. We went 6-inch, 4.5 belt. Very heavy, though. That would mean we were basically immune from like 7-inch guns and lower. We'd really only have to worry about big guns, which don't hit that often. So that could work. Layers. I mean, layers are very heavy. Yeah, I'm fine with that. 0.1 and 1.5. Guns. The turret's 14-inch. Could go down to 5,000 meters at that point. 3-inch on the top. 14-inch barbette. And the 7-inch guns. What, 6-inch should be fine? Yes, yeah, 6. 6-inch, 1.5 on the top, and 6-inch barbette, 5-inch barbette. Okay, that's fine. This also saved us a bit of weight. And then the casement's just splinter-proof stuff. Oh, I didn't never even change the length. That actually changes. I should have done that first, shouldn't I? I'm a prat. Right, we want... Okay, we can't get 40s yet. Okay, let's go for 38s. A historical length, but... I normally go for like 40s and 45s, but let's go for 38s, because I can't make 40. The 7s... I think actually I'm going to make shorter to 40s. And the 3-inch 30s. So they're all pretty short guns. How does that change the pen? Not too much. Yeah, not too much. So we should be okay bouncing most of the stuff that is thrown at us. Which is nice. And now we can get some of the nice to haves, like maximum bulkheads, so we don't sink, spacious crew, so we don't burn down. And yeah, we're not getting any range out of it, but and then we're done. So yeah, not everything I would want, but I think that's pretty solid for a pre-dreadnought. You know, those 7-inch guns can actually be pretty dangerous if we come up against anything that has less than 6 inches of armor on the belt. It's going to be in a lot of trouble. So good for dealing with lighter ships and cruisers. Maybe getting some hits on the extended bits of enemy capitals. And then we've got the big punchy 12-inch guns. Probably not going to hit anything, but they might. Accuracy is a little bit better in this mod. And yeah, they don't look half bad. They don't look half bad. All right, they're Kankos. Sure. Safe. Lovely. Right, what else do we have available? Armored cruisers of various types, including a hybrid light cruiser. Wow, okay, that's a funky looking thing. Belted three master. Okay, before I do that, though, we need to actually look at what we're going to be building, which is very important, because these things are 79 million each, and I don't think I have that much money. 4, 3, 6, 9, 6, 3, 600 divided by 79, 307, 900 is 5.5. So we're not going to be able to build a lot of these. Maybe as few as 3, I think. How would that compare to our closest competitors, the Russians? So they have 5 battleships. So with 3, yeah, we're going to go to war almost instantly. So yeah, we're going to need, I think we build 3 of these. 3 battleships. And where are we going to put them? 185 is not bad. Yeah, we're probably going to put them here in Kyushu. Kyushu. There we go. Right. We're going to need some armored cruisers. And I don't want these to be super expensive. So we could go for the armored cruiser 4. Or the 3. But I'm tempted by... That's the... I saw this and I thought the AI had done something really weird. But no, it's a hull that's basically a... Oh, okay, I'm going for this one. This one just looks fun. Looks like an Age of Sail ship, which is just so cool and retro. We're going for the small armored cruiser. 16.9. Ouch. Okay, can we push it to 18 knots? Please tell me we can push it to 18 knots. We're going to have to try. And I'm going to go for 7,000, which should be roughly in the middle, because we don't want these to be super, super expensive. Cool. Funnels. and towers. Yeah, minimal towers. Yeah, I saw this ship and I was wondering what the hell I was looking at. But no, you can it is actually part of the hull, this big mast in the middle. I kind of love it. I'd love to fit two funnels. Oh, I can. Also very funky. Okay, we've got the engine efficiency we need. Okay, main guns. 7-inch guns could be viable here, actually. They're the only Mark IIIs we have. So I think it makes sense to utilize them. For some reason, the camera is quite close and not letting me move away. Anyway, casements. We do have the 4-inch. We're already using 3-inch, though, on the battleship. And I do like the realism of using kind of a small number of calibers. Oh, a double torpedo on the side. That's pretty neat. Okay. Coal, of course. We don't need to upgrade the boilers. We will upgrade the engine, though. Upgrade the engine. It's still a triple expansion engine, which is pretty bad. All the good stuff. Again, standard ratio, base fuse and cap ballistic shells, gun cotton white powder, advanced hydraulics, enhanced reload. I did remember to do that on the battleship, though, right? Yes, good. standard 18-inch torpedoes and a rangefinder. Lovely. We've got plenty of weight, but we haven't really put any armor on. So we know already this thing, especially if we make this a 40 caliber gun. These are different lengths. Okay, that's weird. Anyway, we go 40 and 35. That seems reasonable. So, yeah, 6-inch is going to be enough to protect against our own 7-inch guns. Let's do something weird. Let's go for a uniform belt. So it's just 6-inch all the way around. protecting against deck, pens, yeah, we're not going to need much. Just uniform 1.5-inch everywhere. Conning tower, let's go. I don't know, 8. 5.3 is the maximum. Why is the maximum 5.3? Strange. Inner belt, 1.5. And inner deck exists. 8, 3, 8. Cool. Casement, 6-inch. Oh, okay. 4-inch and 1.5, and we're kind of done. Okay, let's get some nice to haves then. Spacious, maximum bulkheads, maximum range. Lovely. And now let's put it on diet. Can we get this on 6,500? If I lose a gun, yes, I can. What about 6,000? Yeah, we can go minimum displacement on this, and that saves, well, 2 million or something like that. Makes them much more reasonably priced. Yeah, okay. They're not going to be great with only 7-inch guns. We just tack on some more armor. Can we go for an 8-inch main belt? We could. Right, 10-inch on the turret. One or the other. Let's go 10-inch on the turret and just keep that uniform thickness of belt because I find that amusing. okay. Sure. They seem okay, the Azumas. They also look incredibly retro. Like, even for 1890, they look funny with this, which looks like is there for actual sales. But I kind of like it. Very bath toy like. Sure, we're gonna save one. Save that. It looks like I'm just designing everything in one episode. Makes sense. Okay. Right. How much money do we have left? And how many of these can we get? We have, well, near as makes a difference, 200 million, but 199,039,900. And our cruisers cost 19 million. 9,687,880. We could build as many as 10 of these. But I think 5 is the better number. I will let the computer distribute them. I think that should be fine. It should spread them around a bit. Now we have 104 million left. We're going to need light ships though. So let's look at a protected cruiser. Now for protected cruisers, we have very sensible things like the semi-armored cruiser or the light cruiser too, but the belted three master looks so insane. Is it actually any good? It's pretty slow, is the only thing. It's going to be cheap. Probably. Probably going to be very cheap. So these are 6,200, right? So if we could get these in at, 4,000 tons. How about that? The Kitakawa. I love the fact that Japan is basically running around with a bunch of sailboats. I wonder why this hull has this metal-topped texture rather than the normal wood. Really? I can still add towers to this thing? I can put them down there, which is funny. It's yet another mast! No. Go with the one which is just like a little flag. Stick it in here. Yeah, we want this thing to do 18. So basically the entire fleet can do the same speed, which is actually pretty handy. Ooh, triple funnel. It's completely pointless, but is fun. Multiple expansion engine. Hydraulics, there we go. Guns. Now, we could use the same 7-inch guns. They are only Mark III. But I don't think they fit anywhere on this ship. No. Okay, that means we're going to have to look into a new caliber. So, 3 and 5s, I think, would be the most obvious option. If they fit... Ooh, they do. Really? It can't have a forward-firing gun. What is this ship? It's side-firing only. Oh, it's got one on the back. There you go. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, one on the back. But it's because of this nonsense. What is this forward-firing gun you speak of? Casements. Can we get 5-inch casements? Yeah, we can. Hello, game. Thank you. Secondary 3 inches? Sure, why not? Oh, this is very cur- This looks like it has oars and sails. Okay, fun. Right. Harvey armor. Bob it to double. There. All the same choices. Oh wow, I've gone overweight already. That's not a good sign. Haven't even put torpedo launchers on. standard 18s. Yeah, we're going to have to cut back. Maybe just go with 3 inches. Oh, I can't because they're secondary guns, of course. Tell you what, let's leave the pair of 5 inches at the front. And have all the rest as 3 inch. It's a very stupid design. Right, barrel lengths, 5 inch, 40, it's 3 inch. Yeah, 3, I think 30s is going to be fine. Right, armor. 2.5 to protect against a 5 inch gun. Let's go for a 3 inch uniform belt and 1.5 on the decks. No, that's going to be too much. 1.5 extended. Oops. Oh, that's layers. No, we'll just go for layers exist. 3, 1.5. I can't have a bar bit. Casement, 3, 1.5. 98%. Yeah. 9 million? Well, I guess they are half the price of the heavies, but that is still relatively expensive. Can we get the maximum bulkheads? No, that's pushing it. Many. That's the sort we're going to get. These are very minimalistic, but who cares when they look this this quote unquote good. Very retro, very old school design. Again, I kind of feel Japan 1900 kind of fits the bill. They've got a pretty good range, actually. That'll be useful. Okay, and they ballooned to 10 million. So just over half the price. All right, let's see how many we can build. But at 10 million, we're probably not going to get too many of these. And then we're going to need a destroyer fleet as well. We've got 104 million left. And these cost 10, well, nearly 10.2 each. Yeah, we're talking about as max 10. So, yeah, let's build 5. Wow, we are going to be very light compared to our rivals. They've got more everything than us. Although, well, we'll have to, can't compare tonnages yet. New design. Because we're not finished. They only have torpedo boats. We can get a destroyer. Now that is exciting. This will give us 35 knots. I don't think we're going to be able to do it. What's my max displacement? 850. The Shimakazes with advanced front towers. Looks like Japan was like, hey, destroy us. They're our bag. Really? Can I do it with a quad funnel with natural boilers? 5 funnels. Yes, excellent. There's no penalty for lots of funnels these days. And a quintuple stack destroyer has something about it. I quite like that. Can we shove 2 guns up at the front? Now, this early on, I think a 3-inch gun is fine on a destroyer. Especially if we can get 4 of them. And we'll stick the torpedo launchers. The torpedo launcher in here. Oh my god, I've gone so far overweight. That's not even funny. Right, well, let's build the ship I would want rather than the ship I can build, shall we? Let's see how ridiculously overweight we are. Max HE is fine. Base fused, capped, fast hydraulic, gun cotton, white powder, standard, oh no, enhanced, rangefinder, and armor. I mean, really only need to protect against something like a 3-inch gun, so 0.1 inch everywhere. You know, paper thin armor. And we're 24% overweight. Engines. Yeah, engines and boilers. Why am I not surprised? Okay, let's cut the speed back a little bit. Let's go 32 knots. Okay, that saved a lot. And lose a funnel. And then we can shorten the citadel. And we're only 5% over. And now a big one is the hull itself. So we could drop our range a bit. That'll probably help. 7,500 is actually really pretty good for a destroyer in this area. Yeah, 6,000. Okay, for 6,000 kilometer range, we can up that again when we get access to better fuel. And... oh, I didn't put a secondary tower on. And it was all going so well. I thought I had a lot of space. Let's go for the rear tower 4. I don't think the... oh, no, the arm towers are a bit big. And probably too heavy. 1% overweight. God damn it. Can we shave 5 tons off? Yes. Rear tower 2. There we go. Again, with the kind of sailboat vibes, which I kind of love it. Kind of love it. 4 stacks with the little yard arms and everything. Very nice. Very nice. I don't think they're going to do great things, but you never know. And they're certainly going to be more capable than a torpedo boat. Cool. Save. Let's see how many we can build. Hopefully, we can build quite a few. And I... oh, that's a good-looking fleet. That's a good-looking fleet. It's like, why are you thinking about aesthetics? Look at all those masts. Yeah, of course, because the battleship... This looks... very Japanese to me. It's very very traditional. This is definitely a fleet designed by the old guard of traditionalists. Okay, 53,204,540 is our remaining money, and these are 3.8 million. 6,9,6,7,0. We could build as many as 13. Let's build 10. And with that, that'll be pretty much all of our money spent. I'm going to leave the sliders as they are until I get on to the first turn. But yeah, we should be okay with this fleet. We're going to be a little bit on the small side. Let's just hit start campaign. There we go. So let's actually compare ourselves. So we have a total tonnage of 115,000 tons. Slightly more than Germany. Damn. What the hell, Germany? They didn't build any battleships? What on earth? Okay, but we've got 3 battleships, 5 heavy cruisers, 5 light cruisers, 10 destroyers. Very balanced fleet. And yeah, 115,000. So we're smaller than Spain. Ouch. Smaller than Austria. Smaller than Italy. Yeah, we're pretty much the smallest, apart from Germany, who had issues. Right, main rivals. Let's see. Russia, 269. Whew. 21 light cruisers, but a lot of torpedo boats. We should be able to deal with torpedo boats. No problem. So again, with China, they just have 2 destroyers. Okay, fleet. I'm going to leave them on in being so that we can get our crew training up. Finances, obviously we're going to max transport capacity right at the start. And we're going to start expanding the... No, we're not. No, we don't have the money to do that yet. I think given the imminent threat of war with Russia, tech is not going to serve us well right now. 50% is fine. But I am going to up the crew training level so that we can get all of our crews, let's put it to 50, so we can get our crews trained up for war as quickly as possible. Because if we have a quick war and we have higher skilled crews, because they're all going to start out as cadets, if we've got green or trained crews and the Russians have cadets, that's going to be a big plus. What did they put in Vladivostok? 1 battleship, a light cruiser, and 2 torpedo boats. And there's another heavy cruiser up here. A couple more small things. Heavy cruiser, torpedo boat. Okay. Okay. In fact, what about invasion targets? 129, that's going to be too difficult. Might be able to take the Sakhalin Islands. Possibly the Kamchatka Peninsula and southern Siberia, now that it's a split off province. And then we'll try and put pressure on the Russian Far East. But yeah, we'll attack north, basically. Is the rough plan. Yeah, okay, research. Okay, those times are all looking relatively long. That's good, because it's one of the things I've been trying to adjust. Because tech was just going way too fast. Tech in this mod should work, that it's relatively slow. You're going to have to pour money into it. It's balanced around you having 100% tech budget, basically, because most players tend to run with max tech budgets. So if you're running at a 50% tech budget, it's going to look a little rough. I also made the priorities less punishing when you use them, because the AI tends to dump all 3 priorities down. That is very difficult. I also increased the various penalties. You can see here, submarines, they're still here, but because of the unlock here, this is going to be doubled. All the research times in here are going to be doubled, so this is going to take forever. But yeah, if you'll notice, if you're ahead, for instance, the auxiliary petrol, we're ahead. This is quite an advanced tech for us. It's 5 years for a head tech, so this is one that's going to take a very long time. But if you're behind, you get a boost after 5 years. So any 1895 techs or earlier are going to be going very, very fast for us, and for the AI as well. So it should be a lot more even in terms of the technologies to make things more exciting. Right, let's see if we can get a war with Russia, shall we? All right, it took about a year, but Russia is indeed our first war. Lovely stuff. Okay, now, let's see if they moved anything around. So Vladivostok is empty, Kurilov is empty, a light cruiser, empty, heavy. I think we go very aggressive. Very, very aggressive. That's not enough, isn't it? 65,000 tons. I'm going to have to scrape together something here. So 65,000 tons. No, because I don't have enough to start invading. Because we only have like 115,000 tons total. So no, we're just going to have to... we're just going to have to sit in port and wait for the Russians to come to us. But in that year, finances are looking pretty good. I've managed to get crew training up to 100%, which means that I think most of our ships have reached trained. Are there any that are green still? Yeah, one or two. But now we're at war. We're going to have to put everybody on sea control. Sea control, sea control, sea control. Lovely. We're also building two ships for Bulgaria, apparently. Research. We haven't really unlocked anything yet. We're getting Mark 3 10-inch guns on the way and Mark 3 8-inch guns on the way, which is quite nice. No new hull in the cruiser. No new hull there. And this is a very long way away. Might be worth trying to get engines done, because this is going to take a very long time. And I would love to get turbines. So I'm going to pop a priority in engines. And I'm also going to pop a priority in small guns, so that we can get the small guns unlocked. And I might put a priority in big guns. Yeah. I am. I'm going to assign all three of my priorities, which I will normally never do, but they're a lot less punishing these days. And that'll be a nice focus for us. Well, I think... Do you know what? I think I'm going to... I'm going to end the turn and see if we get fight straight away and see what happens. Oh, and of course, we have money now. So I'm going to plow all of that into the technology budget. Thanks. War. Okay, and that'll make things go much faster. Yeah, we're going to use this opportunity to get a lot of stuff researched. I should have cut the episode. Now I'm stuck on building new ships. Building new ships does still take a while. Obviously, the mod changes a lot about ship design. So you will performance is not as good as it would be in vanilla. But it's not terrible. The initial versions were really terrible. Okay, China and Germany don't like us. Okay, oh, Russia's been dealing with internal stuff. Okay. Well, we're still looking okay. We're still looking okay. Is Dreadnought really the next one we get? Okay, well, I guess we're starting Project Dreadnought. And I think this episode is long enough, and I'll leave it on a cliffhanger of war. Will the samurais of the sea be able to deal with the Russians? Do they still have a fleet that big? Oh my god, it's even bigger. How are they affording that? The GDP is only 41. Okay, it's much bigger than us. Negative growth. Don't like that. Yuck. Who have we got in charge? Oh, the nationalists. Of course it's nationalists. Jesus. Yeah, the old guard firmly in charge. Lovely. Yeah, we have a terrible economy. That means we've got to get conquering. We've got to get conquering! All right, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again soon for some more Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts. Bye for now.